Hey everybody, Casey here, just enjoying the simple pleasures of the food chain. Well, not only are fruit and vegetables a part of the food chain, but you are too. Don't believe me? Well, check this out. At the bottom of the food chain, we have things like plants that capture energy from the sun and convert that energy into nutrients that plants and animals use to grow and live. Now, since green plants and their microscopic cousins like algae are the only organisms that can produce these nutrients from the sun's energy, they are called producers. All other organisms must get their energy from eating other organisms, either plants or animals. In the ocean, the producers include microscopic plants called phytoplankton. Phytoplankton are eaten by microscopic animals called zooplankton, or even some fish, like sardines. Animals that eat living plants or animals are called consumers. On land, grasses and shrubs are the producers and are eaten by small consumers like insects or large animals like horses or cows. Sometimes bigger or stronger consumers eat the smaller consumers. The connections between all of these organisms are known as the food chain, or sometimes the food web. Unfortunately, animals lose a lot of energy as heat when they run, hunt, and play. That's why as we move up the food chain, there are less and less of the top level consumers like sharks, for instance, and much more of the smaller consumers like sardines. Eventually, all producers and consumers die, and when they do, the final organisms in the food web make their debut. Decomposers break down dead animals and plants, releasing their final energy and recycling nutrients to become raw materials that other organisms will use to start the cycle all over again. Well, I think I'm gonna take what I didn't finish out to the compost heap and let the decomposers do their job. Clock's a ticking, so I'll see you next time.